So then, here we go. New leather crafting project. Gonna make a little leather cuff bracelet with a spring rune motif. Get some runes on there and some markings. We'll dye it, get it all polished up, a couple of studs, be quite nice. Come around like that. Pretty simple, old scrap of leather that I've had knocking around. Just use one of my burnishing tools just to give me nice neat edges. And I'll be using these to inscribe the runes. I'll use them to go over the edges so it rounds off nicely when I burnish it later on. Pretty straightforward. So we'll get started. So, you know, all this is, it all depends what you want to do and how you want to do it. This is just going to be, like I said, a straightforward leather cuff. Like I said, scrap bit of leather. Smells lovely. Cut it to where you want it, however big you want it. First off then, we're going to get some markings on it to help me decide where I'm going to put the runes. So this should scribe me a couple of lines quite nicely. What I want, just to give myself a couple of rough stop marks. This isn't a how-to video, by the way, this is just me doing some leather work. Too bad. Next up, we'll inscribe some runes. Okay, picked out my runes. Going with a spring theme. There. So next we'll gouge these out, give them a bit more definition, tidy it all up, and then we'll get the holes punched for the clips. then we'll get it stained and burnished. See how we go from there. Excellent. Go. Right, a bit more tidying up, we'll get the holes punched next. Okie dokie, right. Got me studs picked out, some nice like antique brass, so sets you can pick up, quite handy. Yeah, so all this will be used to put the studs on, but not yet though. So we'll put them back in there for now. It's the ones I've picked out I want to use. Could have gone for the bigger ones, but I think these ones will do it. I think they'll be nice as they are. These are might overpower it a little bit. So that can wait for now. It's all in readiness. Another job. But now, yes, just going to put my studs on. So I just need to decide which way around I want it to go. I think we'll have this as the outer. One there. And one there. Lovely job. Bring that back just a little bit. So See, I'm marking through. It's just giving me a couple of holes just to make sure they line up when it's studded. Lovely job. Excellent. So, decoration is on. All my lines and maroons are marked. Holes are punched, ready for the studs. Next up, we'll get it dyed and then smoothed out, burnished and finished. Then we can get the studs in and go for the final polish. Okie dokie then, let's get this done. Got my dye, well used. Some gloves, because you don't want to get this stuff on your fingers. Got the sponge and some tissues. Since I've opened this, there we go. Let's put another tissue down. Don't want too much. There we go. So we'll let that dry, see how that comes out, see if it needs a second coat or not, and then we can look at burnishing and stuff. Yeah, pretty good so far. Okay, here we go again then. It's dried quite nicely. Not too concerned about that because it'll Alright, do a bit of burnishing. I like to use this, a bit of tan coat, some burnishing tool. So that's for doing all your edges. What you can do, you can just wet it and then you rub it. The fact that it's wet and the friction allows you to smooth it off all the way around. Just gives it a nice finish. I just use the tan coat, just works quite well with me. So yeah. So next stage, it's quite a nice shine in it already. Let's get this done. Only need a tiny bit. It's got a lovely smell to it. See, it's rounding off that edge quite nicely. Right, we'll touch it up, perhaps just a little bit more dye, then a final tidy up and we'll get the studs in, coming along nicely. There we go. Right then, back it a bit when this is dried off again. So, looking good. So time to dry, a bit of polish, giving it a buff up. So it's coming on really nicely. Give it a application of tan coat either side now. Just to aid with the protection and longevity of it. Superb. Right, final drying and then studs and final polish up. Fantastic, looking good. As you can see, can be a little bit fiddly. Be better. Nice. Not sure I'll put these on the right way around. I've done this before. one in. There we go, all in. Shined up rather nicely. So yeah, pleased with that. Lovely job. Thanks for watching.